Live from the Santa Barbara neighborhood in Martinez Town, you're listening to 10 Drink Minimum with Chris, Billy, Michael, and Smiley.
Fuck me.
Oh my god.
Funny, dude.
The crazy thing, okay, hello smoke. Listeners, we're 10 Drink Minimum. We just had like a 45-minute technical fucking fiasco.
That was an hour and 15-minute technical fiasco.
We learned a lot. We learned a lot in that time, I tell you.
We didn't learn anything. We were like, it works now. Holy shit, what happened? No, but
we just kept unplugging it and plugging it
but
in.
But I will say, like,
ended up working out.
I learned a lot.
We are a lot better now than we were, say, like 4 years ago. We'd be like, "What the fuck?" Chris and I would be just yelling at each other.
Yeah, I'm mad.
Just start throwing stuff
against
the wall.
I quit.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck your mother.
That's how it used to be.
So we're already at 9. So we're gonna do an hour. So we're just gonna do a 1 hour show for you guys. I'm sorry. That's how it happens. Deal with it. I don't care.
You might have noticed.
We just lost all of our sponsors.
Lost all of our sponsors. There's no sponsors up on the screen as we speak.
Well, welcome to this week's 10 Drink Minimum. It's kind of a lazy weekend where finally we have a weekend to ourselves and not like some kind of crazy event. Well, that's not true. We did have something on Friday night.
That was dope, man. You guys totally fucking missed out on that thing. Like, Billy, like, I want to be honest with you. And don't take this offense, Harlan. I was not looking forward to do that event. I was like, because I don't like working with people I don't know, for one.
Mm-hmm.
Like, brand new, like, you know, hey, this person's going to, you're going to, like, they were going to, here's the scenario. It was a charity event. And they were going to have Billy and I MC this event with a guy we've never met before in our entire lives. And there's a chemistry issue in my mind.
Yeah.
And so Billy's not there. Like, I'm meeting this guy for the first time, and, you know, it's like, first of all, I guess I should say what's going on here. This is Burt's Tiki Lounge in the background.
Oh, yeah. Rest in peace, Burt's Tiki Lounge.
Because Burt's Tiki Lounge is no longer. Last night was the last night. We got to host a gig there Friday. We have a green screen now, so that's why everything behind us looks like Burt's Tiki Lounge. We're not in Burt's Tiki Lounge, of course. But
regular studio.
Yeah, regular studio.
But, we've upgraded.
So Billy's not there. I meet this guy, and I mean, he was, you know, he was a nice guy, but I mean, he was like a comedian, and everybody seems to think, like, you know, when you don't do what we do, you just think, oh, well, they're a comedian. They'll just all mesh. They'll just all work together. They know how to do that. No, they don't.
It's like Mike Myers and Kanye.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
So, like, you know, I meet the guy, and I mean, he was nice, but I was like, I don't know how this is going to work. And he's like, so let's script this out. And I'm like, no, I don't want to script anything out. Absolutely not at all. I don't script things out on my show. I don't want to script things out for an MC gig, you know?
Oh, yeah.
It's better if you just fly by the seat of your pants.
Yeah.
Like, it's where you
so
get the
finally
funniest stuff.
Billy shows up, and the guy comes up, and he's gonna do stand-up as well. And he's like freaking out because he's got to do a stand-up, stand-up set. And he hasn't done one in quite a while. And he's finally like, I just think I want to focus on my stand-up set. You two guys, you know, have a good chemistry, so you guys can just, you know, you guys can just host. So I'm like, thank goodness. And it just hits me, and I'm like, yes, okay. And I shit you not, being this motherfucker MC'd the shit out of that thing.
Nice.
When we said it was our last time to go up, people were like, oh, you know, clapping for us.
It was cool.
Yeah. We talked about Pokemons.
Talked about getting laid at Burt's.
Yeah. People, when we got off stage, people would come up to us and they're like, so tell me about your thing, you know, your show. And so they were, you know, they were into it.
I mean, it looked like a comedy set we were doing, but it was just talking shit.
We did this, yeah. We did basically what we were doing here. So we do have a call number, 505-715-6511. But yeah, it was pretty interesting. I did, however, think it was a little, I will say this, I did not think, you know, I know comedy's comedy, and you know, there's no boundaries to it, but the whole thing was, is it was for a battered women's shelter, and the comedian told a joke that was like, yeah, I took my girlfriend to get an abortion, we went and got a coat hanger and a vacuum cleaner, and I was like, wow, that that's a little rough for the battered women's shelter, you know. And they were there, but you know, I'm pretty sure we, you know, probably raised I'm gonna guess around $500 probably for that.
Yeah.
There was a lot of people there. So, yeah, and it was the second to last night of Burt's, and there was a lot of people at Burt's last night. I went just to go have one more drink, so that's why, you know, I'm kind of got it as the backdrop here.
Yeah, I totally missed that. I was like, oh, I can go to that, but then I forgot that I had to like take my mom to the airport at 5 a.m. on Saturday.
Oh.
I was like, that's not gonna.
I completely forgot that I was washing my hair that
night. As much as Smiley talks about his
wait
mom.
Wait a minute. Did you just say you were washing your hair that
night?
No,
I'm just kidding. I just. Oh. I did say that, but that's not why.
Is that a real excuse people still use? Or like legitimate excuse women use?
Just for the hell of it. Like,
well, yeah.
I don't know if any. I've never had it used. I've never used it as an excuse. So
but does it take a long time, I guess?
For if you have a lot
of
hair.
You got, yeah. Gotta wash it and condition it like 3 times.
Yeah, you gotta wash it and condition it. Wash it again.
Wow.
Put a leave-in.
Oh, man. Speaking,
if you're really
speaking
that vain about your hair.
Speaking of long hair, like long, luscious hair, there was like a group of natives there that night.
Oh, yeah.
Like a big table.
Oh, and there was a lot of natives there that night.
And like, so I'm sitting there, and I'm sitting next to people I've just met. And I was like, you see that table of natives over there? All of them have the most beautiful, luscious hair I've ever seen. None of them have facial hair. I can guarantee you their bodies are hairless. Why am I not like them? Because I really would love hair, and I really would love, well, I guess beards are fine, but.
Well, I know why. I'm like one quarter Irish, but which so anyway, you can tell. Look at me.
It's just weird to talk to somebody like, like say, listen, guys, I'm exactly like them. Don't ask me why I don't have fucking great
Don't
long
ask me
locks.
Why I don't look like them.
Right.
I want that. And there's a bunch of native babes, too, and I'm just like, they'll never. But he'll never have me.
Because of your hair?
Because of my hair.
That's pretty funny. So.
You have to go Nakai, dude. Nakai!
What is that?
Be Mexican.
Oh.
He says go for a Mexican girl, which I can't. I don't think they're really into me. Who no who's really into fucking into me is fucking white girls in their 20s. That's the only girl I can get.
White girl in her 20s. Bunch of white girls.
Like, oh my god, you're an anim.
It's so funny because I'm white, but I'm like, I don't really feel like there. I feel like there's different levels of it. So yesterday we were, I was.
you're white level, level 7.
Level Paladin. 7 whitey.
What is level 10, like the beach blonde from California?
Well, so yesterday, like Steph and I went to Vinaigrette, which is a very white thing to say. But
of course you did, is what I would say.
Of course you did, whitey. So then these people walk in, of course they all have like on, khaki shorts, and then like polos, and all the women have sundresses on. I was like, look at these fucking whiteys, man. So I was like, what? You're white. I'm like, I know, but they're way whiter.
Goddamn white people.
I guess there's like some kind of level That's for me. That, for Sorry. Especially like natives. I'd be like, oh, look at this show native. It's all for show. You know that, right? Everybody else in the room, this guy's a fucking show native.
He's just like, yeah, man.
Like the Pomeranians of the Navajos.
What is like is the Uncle Tom of natives? What do they call that? What's the?
I don't know.
If someone's like, I don't know, off the res native, maybe, I don't know.
That'd probably be me. Yeah, I'm pretty white for a native dude. That's probably why I'm going bald.
And you have the facial hair.
And the facial hair. It's like you've hung out with too much white people. That's exactly what you deserve, Billy.
See here, Chris is talking about the guy that shows up at Vinaigrette. With like a polo shirt on and khaki shorts, I'm like, that's what I wear, like, on occasion when I go out.
So I don't know. Like, I'd say like
I basically just got called out being the whitest person.
I have to carry a card with me to prove to other people that I'm Native American.
I don't know. I'd say Chris's cheekbones have risen like a few centimeters last 3 years.
Oh, really? I'm less. Does that mean I'm less white or more white?
No, you aren't more white.
No, less white.
Less white.
Because
high cheekbones.
it's hard to tell.
That's good for you. It's like we've kind of like meshed into like some kind of super non ethnic person.
I'm all Billy. Check out these whiteys, no?
Even though I have more Spanish in my blood than anything, but yeah.
Spanish is white. What are you talking about?
I guess.
I mean, they're like a swirly white, I guess.
Well, they consider it like if you go to fill out government paperwork, they're like, it's white non Caucasian. Is what they're considered, and it was so funny because like whenever I was doing a property management, they'd be like, "Yeah, there's no place for me to fill out here," and I'm like, "Yeah, it's this one." They're like, "I'm not white." They get all offended. I don't know.
Don't call me white.
But then you ask him, you're like, "Okay, what's your lineage?" And then they go, "Oh, I'm Spanish from Spain." So white.
Yeah.
Because that's white, white people.
Or Italian. The little dark, like swirly. But
yeah. So white.
Still white.
Yeah. So
I don't know. There's I don't know. You talked about the Uncle Toms of like Native culture. Just as a whole, it would always be like the Cherokees.
Oh really?
They're the whitest Navajos. And actually, if you're white and part Cherokee, that just makes you more white.
Are Cherokee Navajos?
No, they're no.
What? No,
you said
no.
The whitest of the Navajos.
Wait, some of the natives. I'm sorry.
Oh, I was.
Yeah,
wrong.
It's true. I was just hanging out with my my godparents the other week, and they're like full blood. All right, one of them is full blood Navajo, and the other one's Zuni. But still, I mean, they just refer to my mom as white, even though she's registered in like two clans.
Oh wow!
But they're like Cherokee aren't Indians.
that's how it is.
Wow.
So yeah, so it's kind of a running joke among Native culture as like if you're for Cherokee, you're pretty much like white because you're the lightest skinned. I've seen full blooded Cherokees with blue eyes and just.
Oh yeah,
blonde hair.
Blonde hair, yeah. Well, not necessarily blonde, but you couldn't tell.
No, so yeah.
Well, then I mean, also like they freak out on me because they're like, "Do you dye your hair? Do you dye your hair?" And I'm like, "No, this is the Irish blood." They're like, "Oh, okay," because like all of my Navajo relatives have brown hair, and they think it's really odd that I have black hair.
Wow,
Charles, you dye that? No.
Oh, you
that's just
hair.
The Irish.
That's just the
you
Irish.
Know, usually, when you think of Irish, you always think that it's red hair, never like a different like black hair. It's always red hair.
No, they're like Snow White. All my Irish kin are they're like black hair, really pale skin, light eyes.
Interesting.
That's what I think of when I think of Irish, like Colin Farrell.
Yeah. Oh, okay, that's true.
Well, yeah, where he talks, and have you ever heard him like really talk? Like
it's crazy hearing him actually
Jesus,
talk.
Jesus, you're like, dude, you need a translator, bro. It's like, wow.
Like when I think of Irish, that's why I think of.
That's just an act. It just makes him look like a better actor when he does.
Right,
does
right.
When he actually has like a regular English accent.
You're like, you're faking it, dude.
That's I can tell that shit right away. It's like, dude, for real?
You're leaning on two things.
I don't think
you've
so.
Been like you've been in the U.S. too long.
If I walked into like an elevator, I'd be like, dude, you don't have to fuck in front of me. I know exactly what
you're full of shit, dude.
And then he'd be like, thank you. I can talk normal. Yeah, I lived in Ireland like 15 years ago. But I hate put this fucking act.
He still lives there, dude. Oh,
yeah.
Well, he's in America enough, I suppose.
Well, on the occasion when he actually films a movie or something like that. But I'm sure, yeah, he's in love with his Irish heritage. Like, he lives there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, everybody's in love with where they're from. I mean... You know, there's a lot of people that wave the Mexican flag but live here, and then people go, why don't you go back if you love the flag so much? And they're like, well, they like opportunity. You know, they like good jobs with money. Oh, man. So, I don't know if you guys saw the news yesterday, but there was something that fucking blew me away in the news yesterday.
Was it...
Pull back from that mic a little bit. It's...
I don't know. All I heard about yesterday was Stranger Things and the fucking 2 inches of rain we got.
You guys didn't hear about Luke Akins?
Did you say? No. Did you say 2 inches of rain?
2.5.
Oh shit! 2.5.
Yeah, it was quite a bit.
Are you kidding me? The houses in my neighborhood were getting flooded.
It was flooded, yeah.
Well, that's just because of how quickly it fell. But it was actually like I guess technically it was 2.5 inches.
Well, half an inch is crazy.
That's a lot for around here, yeah.
Yeah.
But 2.5. That's.
I had to wait to go out
and
last
it
night.
Lasted.
I had to wait for the rain.
Oh no!
Oh my god! The white girl had to wait.
Also, it lasted for 2 hours, and it took out the entire grid in my neighborhood.
Did you have to light a candle?
Yeah, I was hanging out at my neighbor's house with a candle, drenched wet because that's how wet I got from walking across the street.
God damn.
No, the rain was crazy. Like, I was walking out my door.
And I almost got hit by lightning.
Oh, that's right. I saw that.
The lightning was crazy. I will say that. The lightning was insane last night. All around.
Yeah. But none of you guys heard about this guy,
Luke Akins. I didn't have a TV. Did not have a TV working.
Was he like on American Idol?
No.
No. This fucking guy is the first person to skydive successfully. Without a wingsuit or a parachute.
Yeah.
He jumped from a plane. Can I have a beer as well? and fell 25,000 feet into a net.
I saw that.
On Earth.
And the thing is...
Oh, I don't want that. Can I have something else?
I want that.
We love Santa Fe. Just
yeah, I just I can't have the job. It'll keep me up. But this guy, see, I have to get into this mentality of this guy. It took him 2 years to plan this, right? So let's talk about this because I don't think a lot of people really are thinking like I don't feel like it's getting any kind of like the attention it should. So
no.
this guy is like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna jump out of a fucking airplane with no chute whatsoever into a net that I hope I can target while I'm falling at terminal velocity.
Damn.
And the net was like, what? I think the only thing I heard was like the net was like the size of a football field.
Yeah. Size of a football field. Like, but that's still.
Wouldn't that like have too much like elasticity to it to like hit like make impact?
Yeah. So that's the thing. I mean, I'm sure that they did the calculations. I'm sure they had some, you know, mathematicians and all this shit. But here's the thing that you can't calculate. You're at terminal velocity, and you're landing into a net. What's going to happen to your body when you land in the net? Is it going to fold you up because you were going so fast and snap your spine in half?
Yes. But
well, I'm sure he'd have a body brace going if he knows that's going to happen.
Still, I mean.
But no, but the thing is, like, it's all about, like, positioning your body to, like, catch the most fucking air you can. So when he was talking about it was going to be, like, 120 miles per hour when he
That's still, people die with, like, that in a car accident. I mean, it's almost like if you're hitting a net or the ocean, like water, you're hitting a cement wall.
Right.
A net is not going to do anything. Like, yeah, it has that, like.
And did you see?
Like,
did you watch it?
No.
Like it's amazing. Like, he's just free falling. And they're showing, like, they have the little meter on the video, and it's showing where, like, terminal velocity is at. Like, if you pulled your chute after that time, you still would die.
Yeah.
So he gets right around there, just twists in the air backwards so that he's going to land on his back in the net. Like, it's nothing. And I was like, whoa. And he just lands in the net, and it goes way down and then springs back up, and he gets out, and he's all, yay.
So how high was the net? Did it?
It's pretty high.
It was pretty high.
It's like several stories high.
Let's see.
Okay, that's what I'm assuming. I'm like,
it's not like it was like a trampoline.
Well, no, I'm not also thinking that.
It did spring
him
back up pretty high.
It basically looks like a Wile E. Coyote.
No. It was a third the size of a football field.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's impressive, then. The thing is, like, from 25,000 feet, not only are you free falling, but you have to keep in mind, like, and position your body to fall right into this fucking small space.
Yeah.
That's hard.
Yeah.
Now I'm impressed.
That's where I was impressed. I was like, holy fuck, dude. This dude is really going to. And I was like, I was reading about it. I was like, this guy's going to die. I mean, if he doesn't, this is as amazing as anything I've seen in years.
Was it sponsored by Red Bull? I hope not.
No, I don't think so. Good. Stride, whatever Stride is.
But still, that's like, I didn't hear any publicity about this whatsoever, and you would think it would be up to the par of the guy that jumped from outer space.
Felix Birnbaum.
Yeah. That was the last great one. That was awesome.
That's also entirely Red Bull. Like, everything was just
Red Bull. It was all Red Bull, yeah.
Yeah. But this one's Stride Gum.
Yes. Stride.
So, you know.
Take the stride and jump out of a plane.
So actually, if I watch this thing now and if I see a bunch of stride
shit, that net does not look very big at all. It does it, Smiley.
But
a third. That's only third. It's only 30 yards. It's not that
very
big.
Tall. It's definitely a very tall net.
Like a 30 square yard.
Dude, that is not very big.
No, that's not at all.
It's
not.
Okay, so 25,000 feet, it takes you, like, I imagine a long time to get down. So just trying to, like, position yourself to, like, put you on a target.
So there's a picture of him, like, landing in the net, and there's a secondary net
underneath it.
Underneath. Wow.
Just in case
the net gives way.
I was like, you know, is he going to break ribs? Is he going to, you know... Because that you're,
he has
you're
to
well,
have
the thing
some
is, if you're on your back and imagine at the speed and how much the net would go down, you would just kind of like put your hands would touch your toes.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, it folds you, like,
yeah,
because it came down and it, like, you know, I don't know what how to describe it unless, you know, just watch the video on YouTube. It's there.
Oh, you
he
know,
he has to have the bruising. Huh? Like, he has to have some. Sort
I watched
of
it the other day
back.
And I was like, good fuck.
He probably has like the netting design on his back.
Shit.
Right. Oh yeah.
And you know that now the next person to do that is gonna do it from like the fucking atmosphere, like a free fall from like 13 miles up.
Lack of oxygen.
Yeah. Right. They'll have to have oxygen.
They'll have like just like a scuba mask because they'll take off like halfway through.
That is the question now. Is this thing gonna be like?
It's gonna be broken within a year.
Is it gonna now start?
That takes a lot of planning.
Red Bull is gonna fucking get on this.
It's Red Bull's all, oh, hell no, Stride Gum.
Oh, Stride Gum, you going to go at the fucking king?
Of the extreme sports?
Right. Have you ever seen, like, their facility in, like,
sports? That's just insane.
Norway or whatever?
No. I would say, like, as much as, like, I'm really over marketing.
Yeah.
They do cool shit. Like, I would say, like, every extreme sport thing that I like to watch, Red Bull's behind.
No, and that's why they're so big is they do like the random, like they have they that one where
no one
you
else
build
does, yeah.
You build these like random flight apparatuses that are not really going to fly, but then you run them off of a ramp and hope that they fly. And it's this huge event that they put on. I'm not sure where they do, but all these people like
oh, the Flugtag?
Yeah, the Flugtag.
Watch this dude. And he's just going to twist an air, smile an air watching it. But yeah, they do the Flugtag.
That is big news, and I think people should be more aware of this thing.
Well, I'll see, like, he just turns, boom. Like, right before he hits the net, he just turns and just goes, boom.
You know what would have been the best thing, and I don't want to bring politics, but he should have had a sign as he was jumping out. It was like, don't vote for Trump, and then jumped.
That would have been awesome.
Yeah, and then he dies.
He's like, this will happen if you vote for Trump.
I mean, I can't even imagine that velocity. I've never jumped out of an airplane before. I've never bungee jumped. I mean,
that's intense.
I hit a parked car once going 75 miles an hour, but I was about it.
Terminal velocity. That would be bad. I don't know.
I can't believe he survived.
He survived. Now he's
with no injuries.
No injury. It doesn't say he had any. I went to read it, and I mean, if he did, I mean, he was doing real well not to show him. You know. Mm-hmm.
So he walked away. He was just kind of waving and doing shit.
Doing cartwheels?
There was. I don't know. Like, I read fucking clickbait all the time. So when you do click this article about this guy jumping, and there's one underneath it about the woman who survived a 30,000 foot plane crash.
Really?
And she's the only survivor.
So it'd be, first of all, awesome because you lived. But then also you'd have that survivor's remorse.
And no, she can't. She's paraplegic now.
Oh, never mind.
Yeah, she.
That all sounds fine.
She survived, but she didn't barely survive.
She's all on blog me.
She's all shoot me.
Let me go.
Jeez,
smiley.
I had a DNR.
Really? I mean, come on.
That'd be tough. Yeah.
That would be tough.
I'm religious. I believe in reincarnation. Underneath. I'd be like, kill me now. I can come back later.
So that she became a smoker after she was paraplegic.
I don't know, but can you still talk when you were paraplegic? Like effectively?
I don't think people talk to you, but
do you just like gurgle and blow into straws?
I'm just kidding. That was terrible of me to say. Live here from Burt's Tiki Lounge in the heart of downtown Albuquerque.
So you should have been that should have been your comedian's joke that night.
What's that?
It's like, I don't know. Can you fucking do things when you're paraplegic?
Yeah.
Blow bubbles?
Bubbles. You want to see little Johnny's bubble trick? Nah, I seen it.
Kill me.
I saw it at your birthday. Oh, man, that would be rough. Rough and tumble, man. Rough and tumble.
We're going to get so much hate mail.
Oh, yeah. They're going to be like,
no.
The thing is, like, hate mail.
That's it.
Is hate mail still a thing? Other than because now people have gone the easy route of just like talking shit on Facebook, and Twitter.
They're
like
trolls.
The original trolling of the letter.
Yeah, so there is no more hate letters anymore. I don't think there's any more.
That's how you know that son of a bitch that wrote that letter or wrote to the Albuquerque Journal was old. He wrote a letter to the Albuquerque Journal.
It's like, I'm
let me put it in the mail. I'll wait for Earl to come and pick it up.
He even paid a stamp to put it in there.
Mm.
It's like, you know, people take their frustrations out on forums, dick.
Yeah. It would have took you a lot less. See, that's the thing that I think.
They might as well just call them the Amazon man. Now.
Right.
Where's the Amazon man at?
Right.
He's supposed to come here with my packages.
With my
Amazon
packages. Now, see, now if you flip that around, everybody's like, well, you know, you use technology. And you're like, I'm like, correct. but I don't know how to use the post office. Like, if I go in there, I'm like, so I have some forever stamps. How many do I need to put on the letter?
One.
And they're like, one. I'm like, okay, so it won't come back? I don't want it to come back. I don't want to waste that kind of time.
Oh, man.
That's me. Like, I'm the opposite. And then they're like, I'm picking up a package. I have the little red thing in my hand. And they're like, are you just picking up a package? I'm like, yeah. They're like, you don't need to wait in line for that. I'm like, oh, all right. I didn't know. I had no idea how this works.
That is true.
See, I've got no clue.
Oh, God.
There's been times where I've had to take packages to the post office. And at first, I was just, like, waiting in line. Like, are you just dropping off the package?
There's a like, thing yeah. over there.
Well, yeah, this was, I didn't realize, because I was doing it, of course, for my mom. And so I thought I still had to go, like, get the postage done on it. And then, like, oh, no, you're taken care of. You could have just dropped this off, like,
yeah.
10 people ago. I was like,
oh, yeah, sorry.
Like, really?
Yeah.
Like, all right.
And you're, like, yeah. waiting behind the guy that's getting his passport in paperwork in. And it's like, they're like, this is going to be half an hour.
They just, speaking of passports, they just installed the passports expedited.
Oh, really?
Over at the main yeah, post office
right
here.
Main right across Teddy Corner to us.
Really?
So interesting. You go in there and like, so you don't have to wait. There's like actually a passport person now.
Oh, there's a person that cool. just does that.
You mean again? Because they took him away for a while.
Yeah, yeah. It hasn't been there, but now it's there again.
Well, see, I had a girlfriend. And we ended up being long distance relationship, and she actually liked writing letters, so we actually wrote letters to each other.
Were you dating an old lady?
No, I wasn't. But come she on. Was like,
were you dating a little girl?
Did she send you?
Ew, no.
Was it a pen pal?
What the hell? No, it wasn't a pen pal.
Michael, rub my varicose veins for me. Oh, that feels good.
I send you so much.
That
game.
Is so gross.
Can you throw that over on the duvet?
on the
yeah. roll up the boobs and put them on the
mattress. Gonna grab it's just place it on the hope chest.
Yeah. No, not that one.
Let me show you how to make soap.
When I was a little girl, my grandmammy would put me on the fence and show me how to chew tobacco. Oh
God, you're just making this sound gross.
Mumbly Peg. You guys ever play Mumbly Peg?
No.
Nope.
Oh, that's this wonderful Southern game that my mom told me about, because apparently it's what she played when she was a little kid. You just put your hand on a stump, and you took your pocket knife, and you threw it in between your fingers.
Oh, gosh.
And whoever could do it the most without sticking their finger won.
Well, so somebody would stick their finger because they would lose.
Yeah, the loser stuck their finger.
Oh, that's gross.
That's an old person game.
Mumbly Peg.
Yeah.
Is generally played between two people with the aid of a pocket knife. In one version of the game, two opponents stand opposite one another with their feet shoulder wide. Oh, see, I have seen this one where you throw the knife and try to get it between their legs, right? To stick in the ground near his own foot as possible. Yeah.
My dad was kind of a pro dart player when I was a kid. And my brother and I would, like, stand in front of his dartboard and, like, throw darts at the dartboard and try to, like... You know, I got stuck in the neck one time.
Oh, wow.
I stopped playing.
All right, I'm done. Game over.
Yeah. Oh, my God. It's sticking out. Don't pull it out. Don't pull it out fast.
Don't. You want to pull it out fast.
Yeah. So
know, yeah.
You're like 10. You don't know. Yeah. I could have fucking stuck my eye. Poked my eye out.
I actually had a friend who stabbed her own foot with a dart. It fell like she was like shuffling them around in her hand, and it just fell just right and like stabbed her in the foot. And we had like she had bled through her foot and everything. From the start.
The shit we would do as kids, man.
Like, I was just stupid, yeah.
But that wasn't like an accident. She didn't on purposely like drop it, but it was like, you idiot. You stabbed your own self with a dart.
All right, I want to know this. Out of all the stupid adolescent games, did anyone in this room ever play Chicken?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no.
I've never played it. That's with cars, right?
Yeah.
Well, you could also do it with bikes as a kid.
Oh. I didn't. No. Yeah, you ever like recklessly drive a car towards another one of your friends?
Oh,
to
yeah.
see
oh,
who no. would swerve first.
Yeah, and then he couldn't get out, and he's dead. He went off the cliff.
That's like a small town game.
Yeah, no, that is definitely.
As ghost is helping my son.
See, now there's like,
or he,
iPod games or iPhone games and
you play
pornography.
Chicken on an iPhone.
Right.
Keeps us from like, that's like a survival tool now.
When I think of the chicken game, I think of a. Footloose when they do it with the tractors.
Oh yeah, right.
They drive one of the tractors into the arroyo.
Right.
Well, even like games like as a kid, like Red Rover, those are extremely dangerous.
Oh yeah, Red Rover was
I
like
love
you,
Red
just,
Rover,
you
yeah.
dislocate a shoulder doing that.
You run and try to bust through the yeah. crowd of people. Yeah. Dude, well then there was like amazing games like Smear the Queer, which you would just like basically whoever had the ball, you tackled them and beat them down until they threw the ball away, and then whoever got the ball, you beat them down and tackled them until they threw the ball away.
What is called Smear the Queer?
You never played Smear the Queer?
No.
That's
I'm surprised, and I'm from Arkansas.
Let's see. I'm looking it up right now.
He's from Clovis, guys. Uh-huh. Or he's from Grady.
Okay. it's also called Muckle Muckle. Muckle the man with the ball. Kill the guy with the ball. Or Smear the Queer. See? So it's not like something I made up, you know?
I just remember playing a lot of tag.
Okay, here we go. This is the Urban Dictionary version. Smear the Queer is a childhood game of tag involving an object that is held by the It Kid until he is tackled and forced to give it up. Smear the Queer, how it works, the kid who has the ball or stick or balled up shirt or whatever object is used is it and therefore the queer. The rest of the kids chase the It Kid down until he's tackled, usually in a dog pile fashion.
I do remember this game,
the kid caught so then tosses the object away where the other kids gather around it and wait to see who has the guts to pick it up and start running. It's, you know, what's
but
that?
What happens if the kid doesn't drop it? Like, what if he just keeps
in his
hand?
Oh, you just keep crushing him on the ground.
So the game never ends.
It's, yeah, it's one of those, it's not a, this isn't like a, you know, like,
well, I mean,
there's
you
no
can play
winner.
Tag your eight or
there's
you can
no winner.
The
there's only losers.
It seems like it would be a way to like tackle a person without getting in trouble. It's like, mm-hmm. Oh, Smear the Queer because he has, you know, a lunch pail.
No, it was usually ground. A ball. We never did it like I didn't never do it like just for the fun.
No wonder we all.
The other harsh game that I'm sure that they don't allow him to play was wall ball. Wall
oh,
ball
yeah,
was.
I remember wall ball.
Yeah, that was. But that one, you could really hurt somebody. But you're like, right? You're like, all right, man, you drop the ball three times. Go get up against the wall, and we all get to throw at you as hard as possible.
Oh, geez.
Oh my God.
You know, right in the back.
Even to some extent,
worst was like when someone waltz. Would like, oh, when someone would get it behind you, so it's smacking your head.
Oh,
go back. and then you can't even block them anymore.
Right.
You're seeing spots.
Then there was like the crazy rules, like if you had to go up against the wall, if you have to go up against the wall the third time, then you had to face everyone. You could cover your nuts though. Yeah. It got a little, you know, out of hand.
It wasn't like you had to run up to the wall and everything.
You had to tag it, yeah. He's asking for a beer. You had to run and tag the wall. Like for the kids that are listening now, wall ball was everybody faced the wall, and whoever had the ball would throw it as hard as they could against the wall. And as it came back, without any interference, you tried to catch the ball. If you caught it, no problem. Then it was your turn to throw it against the wall. If it hit you and you did not catch it and it touched the ground, you had to run and touch the wall. And if someone picked up the ball and hit you with it before you touched the wall, then you had to get up against the wall.
Or if they hit the wall before you got to the wall.
Oh, I didn't play that way. It was
no, I guess that was maybe the safer version. You had, like, the person... If you had to race to the wall before someone got it.
We're really? Talking about those you? Giant red plastic balls, right?
Mine were
no,
the, no
it
mine
was like racquetballs.
We played
like
with racquetballs,
balls.
Yeah, or tennis ball. The racquetball was worse.
I'm pretty sure I haven't seen one of those, like, I know what the ball you're talking about, the red, God.
Takahara dodgeball? Balls?
Yeah, you don't see that shit anymore.
Dude, the worst, okay, so when I was in the seventh grade, this is I still have PTSD about this.
The noise it would make.
Ding, bonk, oh, so when I was in the seventh grade, we had to play, we had PE with the eighth and ninth graders, and we had to play dodgeball. And they had the big dodgeballs, and they had the little ones. And I remember I got knocked completely out. I was going for a guy, and I was running, and I went to go throw it, and somebody came to my blind side. It hit me directly in the head with one of the small ones, and I just remember hitting the ground.
And the thing is, like, you throw like something at that in like fucking full force, the legs would go sideways.
Yeah.
You'd fucking land on your side. I've seen it before.
Super dangerous. Yeah. I saw this kid get hit in the stomach with a big ball, and then when he pulled his shirt up, he had a bruise, and it was in the shape of the little lines on the the ball.
I've had dink, the seams from dunk. I've had the seams from a softball on my leg.
Oh God. Well, then I think that once I was like a ninth grader, they wouldn't let us have PE with a seventh grader. I was so pissed because I wanted to throw.
You're going to get revenge on this.
Yeah, I wanted to. I wanted my turn.
You can take your revenge out on these little kids.
See, and it's I remember
go ahead.
There was this kid we called Grasshopper. He was like super tall, lanky, awkward, nerd guy. and very unathletic. Uh-huh. And he would hide. So the coach would get mad if he hid, and then he would make everybody move out of the way, and he would let like he would like pick like ninth graders to throw the ball at Grasshopper.
You know, no like, wonder there's no more gym classes in school
right,
anymore.
Right. That's like bullying at its finest. Thanks, you know, thanks, right? Gym teacher.
And I think that what I did, and it was a great strategy, is like when you start at the center and then you run away, you kind of like disperse in the middle. Well, I would pretend I was on the other team and then start throwing them into their backs. It's like it was a great strategy.
What? How would you get on their side of the?
They just kind of sneak over, and then no one would know because you have like
you can't cross the line.
Well,
it's called cheating.
Yeah, it is called cheating.
It's a great strategy. Everyone knows this.
I mean, if you just want to take somebody out real quick.
So you put the balls in the middle, and like all the guys run up to get the balls.
Yeah, everybody converts.
Well, I would run up like on the side. No one would notice the big fat kid, but I pick up the ball and just keep running. And then so like.
Oh, so it looked like you were just running back to safety.
Yeah. No, I know how you take the ball and then run back.
Yeah.
Pick up the ball and then keep going.
No, that's
so
what I mean.
So you switch teams.
You basically, but you were hitting him from the back.
Yeah, I was hitting him from the back.
But then, what happens, they didn't like, say you were offsides? Never.
No.
Wow.
That was rules?
Gym class didn't really have rules, really.
Oh, I did. From you
yeah, you kind of had those rules.
There was no offsides rules for me.
One of my favorite,
that doesn't
like,
make any sense. Dodgeball, you have, like, you have the middle, the half-court line.
All I ever did was hide behind other people because I was small.
Well, yeah, you do that, but you have your, like, you have, one of you, one team has half the court and the other team has half the court.
Yeah.
And if like, you're caught on the wrong side,
yeah, you run up and get the balls and you run back. And you,
yeah,
you
but who's going to catch you?
You have a, like, you have a referee.
They go, wait a minute, you just switched teams.
It's called the gym teacher.
Yeah. I remember, okay, so.
There's only one of him.
Like, from that, like, I remember when I was in college, we had to do Greek week, and they added dodgeball.
Oh, yeah.
And all of my team got eliminated but me. And I outlasted, I took out four people, and then finally somebody got me. And they were like, wow, dude, you're good at dodgeball. I was like, I had to be.
Survival of the fittest.
Back in my day.
I remember Greek week. We did. I loved. Mine was tug of war. I love tug of war.
Yeah,
is what we did.
Nice.
I remember pyramid, and I was always at the bottom. You did the biggest pyramid
in gym class?
No, for Greek week. You had, so you could do a pyramid the fastest.
Never did that.
Oh, we
didn't do that at UNM.
We did. Yeah.
We had the whole Greek games and everything like that. Like a tug of war was one of them. We had like a relay course and all that stuff.
Right. There was all kinds of different stuff.
I would it really changes. Wish that it would have been like, because I was kind of like in the, when I pledged, it was kind of the alpha beta fraternity, like the assholes.
Yeah, he was in the asshole one.
And so I was kind of envious. Well, back then I didn't care, but.
Ooh, alpha beta.
I don't know. The other games I remember like from PE though is like we'd play like stickball. If it was like wintertime, we would play stickball in the gym.
It was like
baseball, but you had like instead of
we did kickball in the gym.
Kickball too, but stickball was like basically like baseball
with a larger ball.
But you used a smaller stick, you used like a rubber ball, like the racquetball. Use like a racquetball and then like a broom handle.
Yeah.
And you had to hit the, you know, and it was weird because like they could bounce the ball off the, they had to bounce the ball off the ground or something at you, and then, you know, because it was harder shit to hit the ball with a broom handle. I don't know, it was weird, but
this sounds like cricket with a smaller bat.
No.
Yeah, and then there was wiffle ball. Did you ever play wiffle ball?
Oh, wiffle ball and badminton. Wiffle ball and badminton.
I love throwing a wiffle ball because that's how I learned how to like do curves.
There's no like force behind a wiffle ball. It sucks.
It's kind of tough. It's kind of tough to throw one, but still able to. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, when you're still like when you've grown up playing like softball or baseball in like a little league, then when you go into a gym class and you're like made to throw a wiffle ball, it's weird. I think in my mind, like it doesn't go as far with as much force.
Smiley's like, I was homeschooled. I was.
Yeah, his mom didn't let him do PE.
If this wasn't a sport that happened before third grade. I don't know what the hell you're talking about, unless you're talking about soccer.
Yeah.
But see, yeah, cricket, though. I was actually watching a cricket game, and I was for like a good 30 minutes trying to figure it out. I still couldn't figure it out.
And it's real easy. They call the pitcher like a bowler.
It's, because you have to hit the ground first. So you're bowling it, you're not pitching.
Oh, okay. So does it bounce off the ground?
Yeah, it always bounces off the ground.
I don't know. People
throw that ball crazy quick too.
It's like Yeah, and it's wooden. There's nothing. If you get hit by that,
you're, that hurts.
But they break bones.
But how they were like, when someone would hit the ball, and like being it, I guess pitched back, and like there would be a scores being tallied. Yeah,
like
at this
you're
point.
You're running like between two sticks, right?
Yeah, and that's like the scores.
Yeah,
right?
You're trying to hit the wicket gate.
Total right. Like nonsense in the Davenport, to me. I don't know.
Into Chesterfield.
Hopefully you don't get a pain in the Gulliver.
Seriously, it's basically baseball.
I don't think that's
true. Yeah, but you're running between like two sticks instead of around like four bases, and it's
yeah, so I mean, it's, I, granted, I it's can see easier than baseball.
I can see the terminology, but
right.
I do I do
the rules and how everything goes about is completely
someone bowls
different.
Someone bowls a pitch at you. And then you try and hit the ball into the wicket gate. And if you knock over the entire wicket gate, you get the run.
Oh, okay.
And you know there's like...
So what is with them like running back and forth?
If they don't get the wicket gate, then they have to run back and forth.
Like how many times before like it counts as knocking over the wicket gate? None?
I know there's a bunch of nerds at right? UNM that play this in Johnson Field like every weekend.
Yeah. Right next to the rugby team and the lacrosse team.
It's all you cricket nerds.
Getting beers at the Slice Parlor on Thursdays.
But the point of it is you're throwing like a wooden ball at someone and smacking it with a wooden bat.
Interesting.
Nerds! At least people that play in Albuquerque. I'm sure there is some frickin' cricket jocks out there, especially Australia. New Zealand and
it's like a weird like baseball golf hybrid.
Nerd.
I'll say this: one thing I have seen on Johnson Field a lot is lacrosse. Actually, and that's
lacrosse,
one I kind of
figured out. I always thought that would be fun to play.
It's crazy.
It's like you throw it's like hockey, but you're on a field.
It's field hockey mixed with like football because they like slam into each other pretty hard.
That's true. They wear pads and stuff. Yeah. I always wanted to try that out, but it seems like it's really like regulated to like rich areas of the United States.
Oh, it is. I mean, we had a team here for a while.
Really?
At UNM, yeah.
Because, I mean, you have a stick with a sack on the end of it that holds the ball, and you throw with that.
Yeah, and you pick it up with that.
Yeah. You can't use your hands at all, right?
No.
Interesting.
It's basically like a college game like for rich schools.
Yeah,
right?
But there's like no pro, so I don't – yeah.
I don't think there's any pros.
It's like regatta.
It's all college.
or
it's very much East Coast.
Rowing
yeah.
crew.
Did anyone ever play rugby here? I played rugby for a while.
I played it.
I've had a couple friends play rugby, and I've actually wanted to get into it myself, but I've never
That is a game that will get you hurt.
I've seen the advertisements when you pee downtown. Like, there's like, do you want to fuck people up? Join rugby.
Right.
It's also like they have a women's football team, too.
The game I could never get into, though, when I was like in elementary school and people loved the shit out of was tetherball. I was not that. I hated it.
I love tetherball.
No, can I have a beer?
That's that thing where
you hang from the pole.
It's in a pole and there's a string with a ball.
You see how many. Yeah, if you can get it all the way around.
If you're a tall person, you have the advantage.
Yeah.
Because you can just hit it. Above them.
Well, and it's whoever's like the most aggressive as well. You're just like bang, 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 bang. You have timing. I don't know. I hated it.
Whip the ball around. Yeah.
I'd play me a tetherball, and then I'd lose real quick and be like, all right, done. Later.
It's like Napoleon Dynamite.
Come on, man. Actually try. I'm like, nope. Don't like it.
I had a tetherball for my house. Like, I had my own little tetherball.
Oh, really?
Pool. So.
Oh.
I'm just going to bring up your pool and how we never get to swim in it.
Yeah, thanks. It's only 110 degrees outside.
That was
amazing
on Saturday when I jumped in.
Imagine like going. I get it. It's like, Michael, a word, please.
A word, please. Who's this
old man
and these two Native Americans in the yard?
Who's this Native person you brought into my house?
Yeah.
And she's super. The thing is, she'd be super nice to me though. But Michael, a word.
A word, please.
I paid $300 to get this pool clean last week, and you bring a Native American to our house?
That one guy looks
and
smelly.
And an Irish dude.
And an old man.
And some bearded old man.
He looks almost dead.
I wasn't going to say anything, Michael, but...
they can hang out today, but I don't want them to be back
Never
here.
Never again.
I'm just saying I had to unclog the filter.
Yeah.
Had replaced the whole thing.
Yeah. I don't know what you think you're going to do here, but you know, who's going to live with the children? Neither side will care about the children. You're like, what?
I was like, what are you talking about? What?
Is your mom closeted racist like that?
No.
Oh, she's just out in the open?
Yeah, she's out in the open with it all.
I think
she'd be more uncomfortable with me bringing
I remember my grandmother and my grandfather one time.
My mom is actually racist. It's really weird against like other races. Well,
mainly black people?
Mainly, yeah.
I'm pretty sure if I brought a whole like a house full of lesbians over, my mom would flip her shit.
My sister was like had a friend who was like Middle Eastern.
Yeah.
His name is Khalil. I'm not sure if he was like Pakistani, but anyway, it was one of those things where like Angel. A word?
Yeah. Your mom's like, Michael, a word. That boy over there, that's Sarah. Well, anyway, Sarah, she was in the pool, and I don't think she showered today.
I have racist parents.
Billy might be able to get this. My godparents had an African-American woman named Jenny.
Wow.
That worked for them.
Oh.
And her real name was Jenny?
Her real name was Jenny.
But they call her Ginny.
Ginny.
Ginny means black.
Ginny.
Oh.
It's not necessarily. Well, Ginny means. Well,
I was like, was her name spelled like really weird?
No, no, no. Her name was Jenny.
Jenny.
J-E-N-N-Y.
Well, I mean, that just sounds like, okay, like, you know, in Yiddish. Jenny. In Yiddish, there's.
I got your number. Like, seriously, no.
Now, is that like the Navajo word for the N word?
But for, yeah, kind of.
Okay. I mean,
well, when you say black, you say Slijin, which means black.
Mm. And
it's a shortened version of black is Ginny.
Ginny.
Oh, okay. I see.
So, yeah, in Yiddish, it's like Svatza. It's like same thing, yeah. It's basically.
But then they just cackle to themselves.
Right.
They go, hey, Ginny.
They go, look at this.
Oh, God.
That's
funny, but.
It's basically the same thing.
Yeah.
Like, as Jewish people, they're like, ah, look at these Svatzas across the street. Ah! You're like, oh, what is it? And, you know, the other people are like, what is that? And I'm like, nah, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It's the same kind of thing.
Yeah, kind of.
It's
just
be racist. It's,
just casual racism. Yeah. I'm like, no one else gets it.
Right. Casual racism.
Just because your name sounds like another. It was so bad.
Wow.
Jenny. God.
Dude, Alan, don't stop that. Do stop that.
That's terrible.
I'm going to start calling your Jen.
Yeah, Tay Jen.
Anyway, we're live here from Burt's Tiki Lounge downtown.
Oh man, we're talking about racism.
We got the bar behind us. They let us in. You know, there's no one here, so they let us in the
exclusive
door. If you just tuned
right.
in, we're just sitting here in front of the bar randomly.
Dude, okay, so it's come to that point.
Were you burping?
Burping and High Life. Is now $4.
What?
Why? From where?
At Burt's Tiki Lounge.
It's not. There's
what?
Really?
What about PBRs?
That
they're
just, at
they're
least
three,
be
they're
like
$3 now.
Those are still three. What? That's still
but
crazy.
But Miller High Life is now $4 now, and it's, I've seen it not other places other than Burt's Tiki. It is the $4 at the library.
That's just like the average
price. That's just
price.
Wrong.
It's wrong.
Oh, my God. Like, I remember the $2 High Lives when I first moved here. And I guess that's...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I guess double the price in 10 years? That's insane.
Yeah.
In 10 years, that's about right.
No, I'm saying, like, I'd say maybe, like, in 2020, it would go up to, like...
Inflation, man. You got to live the high life. You got to pay the high life.
What you really have to look at is how much does it cost to anodyne?
Yeah.
Anodyne, I'm sure it's still like $2.50.
It's still like $2.50. The thing is, the great thing about Low
is
Spirits
really?
Too is still $2.
Nice.
But at Launchpad, it's more. It's weird because at Low Spirits it's cheaper, but at Launchpad it's more expensive.
And this,
but weird. The best value in town for a still cheap there. Beer is the pint 16-ounce the Tall Boy of Milwaukee's Best at Low Spirits.
At Low Spirits,
the Beast.
Yeah.
The Beast. Yeah.
How much?
It's $2.
Yeah.
Holy I did not know that.
Oh, yeah, for a tall boy. I mean, it's still Milwaukee's best, but, you know,
well,
hey.
Well, what my favorite
No, I'm sorry. It's Old Milwaukee.
Old Milwaukee.
Oh, okay.
That's right, yeah.
But, yeah, so that's the best deal for cheap beer to get drunk. cheap.
It'll get you drunk.
What'll get me drunk is going to Burt's on a Thursday for, what was it, 25 cents, 75 cents?
No,
PBR
75 cent PBR.
75
and they would,
cent PBR night.
They would run out.
The thing is about that, I'd show up and it's already gone.
Yeah, like, one time.
My friends, we went purposely like at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. Like, we
That's
got there.
You guys.
Yeah. You.
It was us. We would sit in the back corner
kill
table.
Kill the keg. Kill
and
the keg.
We would basically like have like an entire tabletop full. And then we would secretly play quarters. So if you got jumped into your cup, you had to chug it. And no one cared because it was just like a 75 cent PBR. But we were secretly playing that in the corner.
Why secretly? Would they get mad if you played that or what?
Well, you're really not supposed to play drinking games in a bar.
Well, it is fucking Burt's Tiki Lines. I don't know. They,
I know.
But, you
know,
like, hey, what are you doing?
Okay, but they did have the tall boys, rest in peace, Atomic Cantina, in the cooler. And you would clear the cooler.
Clear the cooler, man.
And that was fun.
I was talking about that the other night, how, you know, Burt's, you would go there and the fucking air conditioner would die. And so you're sitting there and there's like 300 or 400 people in Burt's.
Or it'd be raining
on you. That
thing
is so hot.
So hot. So then you'd go over to Atomic. I'm almost certain Atomic would sabotage the air conditioner at Burt's. Like, let's
get people over.
Yeah.
Linda's just up on the roof with a freaking wrench all.
Well,
I only went to Atomic a couple times, and one of the shows I remember from there was P-Lander Z. The most insane show I've ever seen was P-Lander Z at Atomic. And then, like, maybe a year later, maybe less than that, they closed down. And I was like, oh, man, that sucks.
Well, then, like, so Friday night was, like, very old school Burt's, where it was packed. It was hot. You couldn't hardly stand it. And then it rained, so there was, you know, the roof was leaking. Yeah. So it was like old school.
I'm kind of intrigued to see how the new spot's going to look.
It's going to open around the 12th or the 15th. So.
Okay.
So it should be.
Because I know they remodeled the old spot before it closed down.
How was the bathroom? Did you sit on the toilet with the no door on it?
At Burt's, yes, I did once.
I meant just now. Because we're at Burt's right now.
Oh, yeah, I did. But, yeah, I've actually had an emergency where I had to sit with the open door. Kind of like,
yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh gosh.
Oh god. I fucking ate.
That's the worst, dude. Where you first of all, you have to shit in public, which is the worst. But then you go there and they have no door on the stall.
Oh god. It's
so you're just like talking to the guy next. And then the door's open. The main door's open.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Are they going to have. I wonder what the bathroom will be like there.
So yeah, it was emerging enough to where, like, oh shit, this is going to happen now. I got to go. And it just happened. It was at Burt's. And this was probably like 5 or 6 years.
Yeah.
Probably
and just so happened, a girl's all, is this the girl's bath? Oh, my God.
And you know, if it's an emergency, it was pretty violent sounding.
What do you mean no? When did they take the door off the stall?
I don't know.
It's always had its door off.
I don't remember, yeah.
Okay, that is not true because I've had sex in that stall, so.
Ew.
There's definitely been a door there at some point.
Yeah. Not since I remember.
Is there only one stall in the men's room?
Oh, yeah.
Only one stall
in the men's room. I know the girls' bathroom because I've seen the door open. There's like a waiting.
There's three stalls in the
We have three stalls. And
there's three stalls.
Majority
in the
of the time, like, none of them lock. But
and there's
have
a couch.
Door.
So in the men's
room. No, there's no couch.
There's like a waiting bench or
Man,
something.
I guess I haven't been there for a while.
Maybe there's like two chairs, but there's
not
a couch.
Yeah, there's some sort of chair.
There's no room for a couch in that one.
Right. So the men's room, here's the thing I've never understood about the men's room here at Burt's, is that you go in there and there's like porn all over the walls. And everybody's like, you don't like that? I go, well, I mean, I don't, what am I going to do with it? You know, get all revved up and go out and do some raping, you know, or just flat out start masturbating right there with the door open and the stall that has no door. So why do I need the porn on the wall? You know, I haven't figured that out yet. And I mean, it's like a collage of porn all over the wall. You know, it's weird. I don't know, anybody else think that was weird?
I cannot say like the women's bathroom had any of that. I can't remember.
In the men's room, you don't not notice it. It's fucking everywhere.
It's the entire like
the wall.
It is the wall. It's like wallpaper.
It's like porn and then like band stickers. And they took the mirror out because I'm guessing it was just like shredded
people kept
up,
breaking it.
Breaking or just covered up with stickers.
Yeah. I always wanted my sticker on the wall, but I forgot to do it. My favorite sticker that was recently there was somebody put, was, I don't know who it was for, but it was like, we drank blood before it was cool.
That, yeah, that's what I was going to tell you about. I was thinking of the Unit 7 drain.
Yeah. Is so that who it was, Unit 7 drain?
So what is this? This is Burt's Mark IV now?
Is this the fourth incarnation?
I believe so, because I remember the first time Burt's closed down and they reopened.
In the same spot?
In the same spot.
Okay.
And then...
It's all like management changes and...
Because the first time it broke down. It closed down. Like, I stole like all the little... Well, I stole two of the pineapple lamps.
Oh, wow.
Because they were like, oh, last day. I'm like, screw this place. Steal everything.
I'm surprised they didn't have last time. Might have. I don't know.
Dude, everyone wants that Captain Ahab fucking...
Captain Ahab
like,
painting.
Fuzzy, like, velvet...
But if you get it, anyone comes to your house and go, oh, you stole it, you stealer. Yeah.
Well, what do you think the people thought when I had my pineapple lamps
up? It's going to be worth a lot of money, I bet, when we're older.
To people that went to Burt's.
Yeah. To me, I'll pay top dollar for it.
I paid top dollar back in 1984.
I'm going to be very interested to see what it's going to look like in their new spot.
I hear it's super, like... corporate tacky now.
Is it really?
It's not divey at all.
Nah, see, that's the unfortunate part, because before they do the remodel at this old spot that just closed down, I love like all the little knickknacks and like memorabilia on the walls. And
I
then,
was sad they got rid of all
and
that.
And then
stuff.
They remodeled it and made it look like more sleek. They changed where the concert, like the
bands
and
they had
up.
Racist shit on the walls. Like if you were in the far corner, they had like old like 50s like tchotchkes that were like people in blackface and. It would have slogans like "Ain't that something," you know.
And see, I had friends that were trying to like sneakily like take stuff
all the time.
And I'm sure there's a lot of people who tried that.
Yeah.
But you can't really.
Yeah,
like,
Smiley just.
I know. Yeah. Smiley just took.
I did it blatantly.
But
I've never stolen anything from.
I just ripped them off the wall and took them.
My friend was actually like hanging from one of like the little beams, trying to break off.
Oh,
I don't.
Wow.
I can't remember what he was trying to break off, but he was like just hanging there.
Huh.
I really should have gone last night. I really should have paid for one of those their signature drink.
Whatever,
that fucking
thing. That's like on fire.
Yeah.
See, you know what I'm. Go ahead.
Well, I was just gonna say. So this new Burt's that's gonna open up. Is it just new? Is it new ownership and it's completely different?
No. Same people.
Just a different place.
Yeah, they're gonna just move all this over. The one thing I was blown away by is all this time. First of all, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Everyone knows this. Burt's, when you go to get a drink, is slow as shit.
Yeah, it's what kind of they're known for.
Never, ever have they ever gotten better. So I was always shocked that no one got pissed and threw a bottle through that fucking fish tank. Always shocked about that. Yeah, eh? Never happened.
That's because the fish tank had a little remote control submarine in it. You could.
Yeah. Who ran this remote control?
Well, one of the bartenders. If it was slow, you could just ask for it.
Oh, really?
And then you ran the remote control, and you just sit there drinking
beer.
No
shit, that's cool.
Scaring fish around.
That's kind of cool. I didn't know that. Little things you need to find out.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know.
So you're looking to the side, and it's not because Michael's a woman that she's getting all her beers. It's just because she's closest to it.
Yeah.
And maybe she's
new. I
think
they can't even see me on the screen. I'm not at Burt's with you
guys.
That's
because you didn't want to be on. I said you can move right there, and you said no.
But then I would have my back to the camera.
No,
so.
You could sit like you're sitting right now.
With your face right here, you'd be looking at me.
Yeah. Fine. It would be weird having my back to you two.
You wouldn't. You'd have it okay to him. Only to him.
I am so frightening.
I feel like this is all your fault.
Michael doesn't want to have her back to me.
It's so my fault.
But you know, it's all
in
all.
Stab me in the back.
Yeah.
I'm going to miss that old Burt's location. Actually, if there were to be like somebody just kind of scoop up that place, just kind of like low-key, make it another dive bar.
Make it a nightclub or a comedy club or something.
Maybe. But there's no more. I guess Anodyne's the closest thing we have to a dive now.
Downtown.
Oh, yeah.
It's basically the only thing I'll go to.
I think Launchpad's divey.
I went
Launchpad's divey.
I went to Anodyne for the first time in like months last night, and I didn't realize how much I missed that place. It was awesome going back there.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun. So, but I think with Burt's, yeah, it might look more corporate. I hope it doesn't do that much corporate, like kind of a look style to it. I really hope.
I don't think it'll be totally corporate, but I mean, I feel like it'll be on the level with like Sister Bar.
Oh, I hope so.
I mean, it's going to be another venue.
I like Sister Bar because they comes with their fucking aesthetic, like just being like super.
I feel like Sister Bar, I hated them when they first opened because their staff was rude as fuck. Now I just go to certain people. I just avoid the rude as fuck people, and they kind of avoid me, which is fine. But the good thing about Sister Bar is they are constantly changing the place for the better.
Oh, yeah. The video games?
That's dope.
Video games are awesome.
And no more smoking on the booth outside.
Really?
What?
Yeah, you have to go completely outside. You have to go outside.
Well, that's not their fault. That's like the rule. They got in trouble for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I really like on busy nights they have
there's three walls.
They have the guy, the cigarette guy inside the bathroom.
I hate that.
Gives you cigarettes and like puts. The thing is like.
That's only in the men's room.
Well, see, I don't carry cash, so I always feel like an asshole. Oh, like, yeah. I'm sorry, I don't have any money to hand you.
You know, my thing when I go out to bars is I always carry a couple dollars with me, or I borrow one from Chris, about going to get cigarettes from certain people. It's like, hey, like, I don't have any cigarettes. Can I buy one off you for a dollar? Like,
you should let people know this.
Eight times out of ten, they'll just fucking give it to you.
And there is and it's funny because they sell cigarettes across the street. It's like a little bit down, but yeah.
It's not. They're not supposed to, but they'll sell you Lucy's at Ray's sometimes.
I'm just saying you go buy a pack.
Oh yeah, well no, but I don't want to buy a full pack. I want two cigarettes for the entire night, and that's why I need a cigarette dollar. But now you got the guy straight up in the in the bathroom. I'll take two.
That has to be only in the men's room because I've never seen that in.
But you've seen the guy walk out of the men's room though, right?
No.
Oh, he wears like a real nice like.
Granted, I haven't been to Sister in a while as well. Oh, like last night was a.
I always hate it when he walks in. I'm like shit. I was like, well, I'm gonna pee upstairs.
And he does actually. Give you your paper towels for you.
Yeah, I don't have any because I don't carry cash.
Yeah, and I find it's awkward. It's like, all right, thank you, bye.
Like, see, I don't think there's ever. But you say it's only in the men's room. Is there ever a women's room attendant?
I've never seen one in the women's room.
I'm not saying there. I'm just saying anywhere.
I don't think like historically, women's room attendants aren't a thing. They've never been.
That's not true, but I've never seen one, and I've never been in
So there was a guy with cigarettes and...
It's not a guy, but it would be a woman.
Shaving, I'm sorry, the cologne and what else did they have? Gum, cologne, and cigarettes, and paper towels.
It would just be a woman instead.
There's just a dude in the women's bathroom.
I think in Vegas, you know what, I think maybe in Vegas, like once, at one of the nicer places.
Yeah, that'd be a good name for a band, ladies room attendant. And so everybody's like, I just typed it in, and it doesn't pop up anything. And someone's asking in a forum, is this actually a thing? So I don't know. Have you ever seen one?
I've never seen one.
I guess not.
Well, of course you haven't.
Because I'm not a woman.
So maybe it is just a men's thing. I don't know. Like, I would have just assumed like it would have been in both, but yeah.
Is it just like a cat?
Yeah. I wish there was
girls. Well, since girls go to the bathroom together for some freaking reason, then I guess I don't need like a lady
room attendant. For some freaking reason, they gotta go talk about. They gotta go gossip. Isn't that what?
That was one thing with me and my ex best friend. Like we agreed that we would never go to the bathroom at the exact same time
because
we thought it was weird.
Like we didn't.
We did not understand why girls always had to go to the bathroom together.
We talk shit about each other about other people.
No, you go to the bathroom. Say hey. Let's go to the bathroom. You go in. One of you would be peeing. It's like, oh, my God, that guy tried to hit on me. He was so fucking gross. It's like, who are you going after whatever this girl tonight?
Yeah.
And that's what you would do, at least in my mind.
We never did.
And you guys probably had, like, pillow fights in the bathroom. Just like
do a little cocaine.
As soon as you walk in the door, you grab a pillow, and then you grab your dollar straw.
You
and
take
you go
your pants off.
Snort.
And your undies.
See, like, I grew up going to the Pulse, so there was just two bathrooms. Or no, there was three bathrooms, but they were all unisex. So they were just other rooms.
Right. Well, that's how FX is. You go in there and you're, like, peeing and there's some girl in the bathroom. And you're like, okay, well, whatever.
That's just them being impatient.
No, they're in there, like, high on something or doing some drugs or something. You know, who knows?
Yeah.
I've only seen it happen a couple times.
I walked into a room. When they were doing cocaine, and they were startled, and then they dropped all the cocaine.
At FX?
No, it was at a green room somewhere.
Oh, I know where, yeah. Whoops.
So I was like, hey, what's up?
What are you guys doing?
You just dropped God, what? Everything. $15 a bump right there?
Oh, man.
Sucks to be you guys.
Whoops.
I'd gone to a pool party, and there was just, like, these two little eight balls, like, just sitting there. Did anybody who wanted to walk up could just do it.
Oh, I've been to several parties like that.
Yeah, it's a culture here, and it's very expensive. I don't know why it is, because we're close to the border, but whatever.
Oh, well. Downtown life.
Yeah, downtown life.
Downtown life. So we're at the... We've gone over an hour. So you guys ready to call it quits?
Let's wrap this up.
Let's wrap it up. I want to say rest in peace, Burt's Tiki Lounge, Gold Street. Gold Street's going to die now. I don't know if it will.
No, Red Door's there now.
That's true.
Red Door is down the street.
We'll see. And then
we
the
still
place,
have Lotus.
Well, the place that was next door to... Oh, that's the crazy thing. Is so Friday night, you know, it was 10% of the bar went to the Safe Women's Battle Shelter, 10% of, like, all merchandise sales. Then it was supposed to be 25% of all food sales in the place next door, but they closed down. So now that place is closed. That tamale kitchen.
I've never seen more than, like, two people in that place.
It was good. I liked it. They would deliver downtown. You know, if you were, like, at a sidetrack, they would deliver food. So that was good. But so that place closed, so maybe... Two different places can open there. I don't know. Who knows? More bars? I don't know.
Just knock out that wall and make a fucking great...
Big super bar. Super bar.
They've always needed to do that, though.
It's just called Blackbird 2.
Blackbird 2. You hear that, Dandy? The Blackbird will never die. It just multiply. All right. I want to thank everybody for watching or listening to our show here at the Burt's Tiki Lounge in Gold Street. I'm just kidding. We're in front of a green screen. Ah, ha, ha. Technology. So we do have something coming up. September 24th, the Alibi Untapped at the Rail Yards Market. It's a Saturday, I believe. We are going to podcast live. Probably not live. We're going to podcast from the Rail Yard. And they're going to have 14 different breweries there letting people sample beers.
Oh, my God. We're going to get trashed.
Yep. Oh, and we have free pass.
Oh, shit.
We're not paying, and we're getting free alcohol.
Well, of course we do.
Of course we are.
Ubers all around.
These thumbs. The Alibi asked us to do this.
Oh, that's tight.
Yeah. I'm actually going to probably help them get the some of the people. Because they're like, we don't know any of the brewery people. I'm like, wow. Well, I know.
Really?
Yeah.
We know pretty much all of them.
A lot. Well, not all of them, but a lot. So, yeah. I was like, you guys need any help? They're like, well, we have ad people that are on them. And I'm like, okay. But if you need help, I know this. And I was like naming them off. She goes, okay, we may need your help. I was like, okay. So, but if you're a brewery and you want to sign up for Alibi Untapped, it's $125 a booth, and I believe it's going to be Saturday, the 24th, September 24th, and it's like, I remember the times, but it's at night, so
we'll have more information. I give it up to Albuquerque for having these kind of like festivals for beer. I have not yet seen one guy like blackout drunk on the floor.
No.
They're all pretty, as far as like Albuquerque culture goes, we're still at that point. If it does get bigger, we're going to see, hopefully not fights.
I don't think so.
But we're all pros down here, man.
Yeah.
We're all
Do you guys
pros.
Have anything else to promote?
We're not going to have a show here in a couple of weeks.
Oh, that's right. We'll be in Billingham, Washington.
We'll have a show for 2 weeks.
That's right.
Yeah, so we'll be in...
We get back in time. I mean...
Oh, yeah, so 1 week. So next 2 weeks from now, we'll have a show.
Yeah, we'll just set it all up before we leave. Just walk in and be like, set it up, you know, it'll all work. But yeah, so check us out. If you're new to the show, check us out on tendrinkminimum.com. We do if you're listening to the podcast, we do our live shows usually from 6 to 8 on Saturday nights. A lot of technical difficulties tonight. Hopefully we won't next, you know, Friday. You know, all the crazy shit worked, but the simple shit didn't.
Go ahead.
I'm done.
I was going to say, we should start out the outro, but then have Michael just say it, because she doesn't...
No, we're not doing that.
But always remember...
Never get too drunk to jerk tendrinkminimum.com.
That's us.
Dang.